Creating virtual events has gotten so much easier in the last few years, but when it comes to creating member-only events, it still feels like there's a dance you need to do between your webinar software, your membership software, and getting everything working properly. Well, today I'm going to show you how, with WordPress, you can easily create member-only events that are shown to either your free and paid members or just your paid members. This is going to be using Restrict Content Pro and the events calendar. Let's get started. All right, so here in my WordPress site, let me first show you the plugins and themes I'm using. First, I am using the events calendar plugin with the paid upgrade virtual events. This plugin, I'll show you it in a minute, but this plugin or this extension will give you some really nice features to integrate with all sorts of virtual event software, including Zoom, WebEx, and YouTube Live and Facebook Live. So whatever your preferred platform is, with some caveats, you can use that inside of your own membership site. For the memberships, I am using Restrict Content Pro. Both of these are owned by Stellar WP, which, by the way, big thanks to Stellar WP for sponsoring this video and for providing the plugins free of charge for me to demo them. So those are really the crux of what I'm using here. I do have the event ticket add-on or the event tickets add-on for the events calendar. I'm not going to be using that, but if you want to collect RSVPs from your members, you'll need that add-on as well. For the theme, I am using Cadence with their Cadence Blocks plugin. I'm actually not using the pro version of that here. I'm just using the free version, but what I'm going to show you should work with whatever theme you happen to be using. I just like to keep everything in the family. Cadence is also owned by Stellar WP. So that is all of the plugins I'm using. Now let's get to the setup part. So I have set a few things up already in the interest of time and brevity, but I will show you what I've done here. So I have two membership levels. One is free, and that is basically just a login. Anybody who creates a login will get this for free, membership level. And then there's the pro membership level, which I'm charging $99 per month for. If we go to the settings, I'll show you the settings I have configured here for the content. There are the automatic pages that are generated when you install Restrict Content Pro. And then the message for Restrict Content is this is for paid members only. You can customize this with the Restrict shortcode. Under miscellaneous, I do have, this is crucial. This is really important for the member-only events, because the way that the events calendar works with the way that they handle access control, it conflicts a little bit with the way that Restrict Content Pro handles access control. And so the way around that is to hide restricted posts from queries that the users don't have access to. This will redirect them to the register page. I also have a redirect for the login page. And any user who is created gets added to the free level. This is important because I'm going to show you I have two categories for events. One is for all members, one is for paid members. So those are the main configuration points for Restrict Content Pro. If we go to the events calendar, I will show you these two categories I have. One is deep dives. This is going to be for pro members only. I have that here. The nice thing about Restrict Content Pro is that you can restrict at a taxonomy level. And so we have our custom taxonomy event categories here, which I'm locking down to the pro members only. And then for meetups, I am making these available to both free and pro members. So essentially what this is doing is saying anybody who has a login to the site can access these member-only meetups. The last thing I'm going to show you here, and this is really important, right, is member access. You can do it at a custom post type level as well. And so we can restrict access to all events if we want. And so we can restrict it based on membership level, access level, or members with a certain role. Membership level is the one that you're going to be mostly keen on here. But I'm going to have this for everyone so that we can configure posts individually because we do have those different types of posts. You also need to make sure hide restricted events on calendar views is checked off. This is important because the way that Restrict Content Pro works versus the way that the events calendar works, if you make an event available to anybody who's logged in, even if they are not a pro member, they will still see the calendar invite and they will still see the call information. So they'll basically be able to join even if they should not have access to those. So hide restricted events on calendar views is the thing that's going to prevent non-paying members from accessing paid events. So I want to make that super clear because there was a little bit of confusion there when I was setting this up. So to show you, we'll create a new event so that we can go through that. But I do have two events. One's a monthly meetup and one is the deep dive in these categories. If we go to view calendar on the front end, I am logged in and I'm a pro member here. So I can see both of these events and I can access the call information. The deep dive is using Zoom. I was testing that, and then I can add this to the calendar. The nice thing about adding it to the calendar is it doesn't include the Zoom call events. It just includes a link to the event page. So even if someone does get a hold of the calendar invite somehow, they will still need access to the site to get the call information. Now, conversely, I have a second login here that is a free member. So I don't see the Learn Dash Deep Dive here, but I do see the monthly meetup because that is available for free members. Now, if I log out, you'll see I don't see any events, which is good because that is the expected behavior. I can subscribe to a calendar. So if I, as the site owner, decide to have a completely open event, maybe I want to have a webinar to get people into the membership, I can make those available as well. I'd probably create a new category called free webinars that are open to everybody. Okay, so let's actually go through and create a new event. So we'll go to our WordPress dashboard. I'll go to events, add new, and I'll show you some of the things that I'm doing for these member only events. So let's create an event. We'll call it Deep Dive Restrict Content Pro. We will add a description here. So now we're going to add a lot. There's a lot of meta information about the events. There's like price and organizer. I've tried deleting all of this information in the past and the events calendar has gotten mad at me. So we're going to keep it for the most part. Most crucially, we need the date. I will say when you set the date, you want to make sure that the time zone for your WordPress site is configured properly and the time zone for the event matches the site's time zone. Otherwise, you'll get some weird errors or weird display issues. So we'll set this to the 23rd. This is a deep dive, so we'll make it 3 hours, 8 a.m. to 11 a.m. Eastern time. Again, we'll leave the price, the organizer, and the venue. We'll keep the calendar. Now, if you are selling events, you do need some sort of e-commerce integration. That and RSVP are both part of the event tickets add-on. But because these are member-only events for me, I am going to just leave those. I want to make these events available for all members. And in this scenario, the recordings will be available. So I'm going to hold these events whether or not people actually show up. As far as member access goes, we did configure that with the categories. So I'll click the deep dives category here. We want this to be only available to paying members. And then we have the configure virtual event section. So a couple of things here. Let's actually jump out to our WordPress site and into events settings. In settings under integrations, when you have the virtual events add-on installed and activated, you can integrate with Google, Microsoft, WebEx, Zoom, Facebook Live, and YouTube Live. Couple of caveats here. Setting up Zoom was super easy. You just log into your Zoom account and it's configured, and then it will create events on your behalf. So if you want to do it that way for virtual events or member-only events, you could totally do that. I'll show you the LearnDash deep dive and how that's configured later. But I like to use YouTube for my events. And so you can add your channel ID. There's a pretty heavy caveat here, though. Since it's not API integration, it's just looking at your YouTube channel, this will only pull in public live stream events, which means that if you have something unlisted or for members only, the YouTube Live integration is not going to work the way that you want it to, or the way I want it to. So with that in mind, if you don't want to use YouTube Live, or you don't want to use the workaround I'm about to show you, you might want to stick with something like WebEx or Zoom for these member-only meetings. But let me show you the workaround. So that's just really quick. You can integrate with all of this stuff in the settings. Going back to our event page, what I am going to do is still set this to YouTube Live, just so that the system knows that there's a virtual event. And then we want to make sure that this stuff is configured too. So embed video linked. I'm actually going to uncheck embed video because there's not going to be a video to embed, and I'm going to embed it myself. Show when the event is published. Show to everyone. This is going to be managed through Restrict Content Pro thanks to the event categories restriction. Include link in RSVP emails, and then show on event page and in calendar views. So there's one more thing that we need to do here, and that's actually add the live stream. So on my YouTube channel, I did create a new live stream. I made it unlisted. This is really important because when it's unlisted, it's not going to show to anybody who stumbles across your YouTube channel. It's only going to show for people who know the link. So from there, I clicked on the view on YouTube link. And we're going to grab this link from the address bar. So let's go ahead and do that. I'll grab this link. Then we'll go back to the WordPress site. And I'm going to paste it right under the description so it gets embedded. So we have deep dive, March 23rd, the description, the live stream URL. And then we have all of the event details here that we're going to keep because, again, deleting some of this is going to upset the time-space continuum and break your event. So we'll click publish, and then we'll view the event. And now you can see that we have our event here. Users can add it to the calendar. Because there's not much information to add here, this is just going to be an embedded live stream, which is fantastic. Maybe you want to enable comments, or people can click through to watch on YouTube and make comments. That's really up to you. If we go to the events page, or the all events page, we'll now see two events, both deep dives. And if we go to our logged out user, again, we see nothing coming up. If we log in to our free account here and then go to events, again, we see nothing coming up. So that is how I and how you can create a members only event inside of WordPress using Restrict Content Pro and the events calendar. I will show you one thing. I do want to show you how the LMS deep dive is configured because we are using Zoom for this one. That might be more preferable for you if you don't want to use YouTube Live, or you know your members are comfortable with Zoom and that's an easier place to do it. I'm going to get rid of this shortcode. It's actually not working properly. So let's scroll down here to the virtual event section. You see I've created Zoom. So I have the Zoom integration. So let's remove this meeting. And then if I just select Zoom without a meeting, we can choose the account. You can have multiple accounts associated with, which is cool. You click next, and then you can choose meeting or webinar. So this, when the events calendar connects to Zoom, it will know if you have the webinar add-on. And if you do, you can choose that. And then create. And this will create an event in your Zoom account. So if I open up Zoom here And then I go to meetings. We can see the two meetings or the set of meetings that were created thanks to the events calendar. So I'll delete these. But that's it for this video. I showed you how you can create member-only events using Restrict Content Pro and the events calendar. And I gave you a quick overview of the virtual events add-on using both YouTube and Zoom. Again, my preference is YouTube because I think it's the easiest. People don't need to log in or download anything. But if you want a little bit more seamless integration or a little bit more security, honestly, you can use the Zoom integration, or if you have a private Facebook group, you can do it there as well. But that's it for this video. If you want to see any more videos about Restrict Content Pro or the events calendar, let me know in the comments below. Be sure to like this video and subscribe for more great content. And until next time, get out there and build something.